Okay, let me know when I'm back, I guess. I'm getting really sick of my computer. I guess I can't stream anymore, even if I wanted to, because that is the third stream in a row where my computer is just completely frozen on me. And I don't really know what I'm supposed to do about that. Maybe I'll just save up a bit of money and then ask my friend Nick to help me pick out parts for a better computer. Because he's good at that. Feel like going down there. I really don't like this system. Double keys, get double keys. Okay, so we got Jay Stills. I have four of them. Yeah, like that isn't much of a hint. We have his. Like, that could be anywhere here. But, yeah, before I stop, I would at least like to finish this game, so I don't just stop streaming and in the middle of a game in progress. I'm definitely not starting anything new until I figure out what the hell. I mean, my computer has been having all sorts of dumb issues. I've just been hating it more and more this past year. First Borderlands. I'll be playing that. And it'll be. I did it on my old computer just fine, but on this one, it just suddenly starts running very slow, very choppy, and it just gets worse and worse and worse and worse until it eventually just freezes entirely. And if I try to control all delete out of it, my computer locks up. It's just like, okay. And then the same thing started happening for XCOM, Enemy Within. My one friend thought it was just like, oh, NVIDIA's a piece of shit and they released patches or drivers that would purposely like screw you up just to make you buy their new stuff. I was like, well, that might be it, but then I tried an older driver and it just made things worse. So I was like, no, that can't be it. Yo guys, is there a bear pod in here? think he's also smart enough to stay out of the field. Or he just can't target me. I'm not entirely sure what's happening with him. Oh, this is the Annihilator Beam super missile. Sonic Boom! A wave of sonic force. 5 missiles, 30 ammo of each type. Most effective against multiple targets in an area. It's just a giant AoE screw you attack. It's just everything explodes. Oh, fuck you. Have one of these. That's what you get, you little shit. So hopefully I can finish this in under 3 hours. Is that the fuck? That seems to be my time limit. If I'm streaming for 3 hours, my computer will just completely lock up. Expansion just hanging out down here, okay. That seems kind of easy. I think we have them all. If it's like the first game and there's only 8. Still hurting. That automatically take my visor off. No. I get into Aegon. Yeah, I think we've explored everything here. No, because that didn't lead to anything either. Shroud of Grounds, maybe? I don't think we checked over there. But yeah, this will probably be my last stream for a while. Because I'm sick. And every single time I try to stream, my computer just freezes. That is so frustrating. Especially since there's no reason it should be doing it. Like, it's never done that before. Or anything even similar to it. And now it's suddenly guaranteed to happen every time I stream. Like, I love technology when it works, but I always seem to get... Wait, it doesn't lead anywhere? How did I get to that? Oh, that's right. I might just cheat and look up where all these things are, because I don't have the patience for this right now. I just want to get this game done with. Actually, wait, hold on. Room. I already checked this earlier. Yeah, you know what? Give me a moment. Since have like a map. Past it in the dark oasis. Is apparently where it is. So let's go all the way back there. I'm just less and less enthusiastic about this as we go, too. I just want this game to be over. I never thought I would have this much disdain for a Metroid game, but I'm just not having fun. It's in the first game, you could get almost every single, Chozo artifact before the end of the game. I think there was like 10 you can get before you even have the Phazon suit. which was just hilarious. I would basically have the endgame side quest done by the time I got to the endgame. Well, it's not even a side quest, you have to do it. It's Metroid, there are no side quests, but you know what I mean. Like, it's not immediately required, but you can still totally pick them up. I just went in a circle, didn't I? No, we're going the right way, okay. Everything looks the same here. That's the problem with deserts. It's just sand in all directions, everything looks exactly the same. That inverted aiming that you can't do anything about. That bugs me. Aiming should never be inverted. Flight controls, yes. But aiming, no. Dark Oasis, okay. Oh. Wow, how did I... just walk right by this. The Ing Storm no longer hurts us, which is awesome. Okay, Dark Torvus Bog. Poisoned Bog and Dungeon. I want to see who that is, but a little busy right now. Where's that portal? Other side of the room. Where does this lead? I could go do Sanctuary. I don't really want to, though. That leads to Torvus. Wait, there's an item in here? Where? Hold on. Hear one. don't get why Aero Troopers always have that song. It's like, you guys are like the least threatening space pirates. You don't have to show them the game right now how this works. Gonna show me anyway. I don't see why that couldn't be done without the Echo Visor. But it wouldn't have mattered because this is unobtainable with all the screw attacks, so. That's one of the ones we're missing. Four more. Okay, where's this Torvus elevator? That way. I apologize if I sound super unenthusiastic right now. Wasn't having the best of days to begin with, and the whole freezing thing is not helping. Feel bad because I haven't been streaming in forever. So I try to do a stream and then computer's just like, no. You don't get to stream. Oh, also that's probably how I get that one missile, so let's do that. Also, wow. Try that again. Oh, come on. Fuck this game. I'm so done with this. Just another portal right around the corner. I already know about this game. I know. We've been there. That was the most worthless hint you've given me. Thank you. crypt, sacrificial chamber, dungeon. There's a thing to sanctuary down there, so I think I'll start with the bog up here. So where is that? It's right over here? Okay. I can't use that portal though. That's the one-way one. There's a good way to get there. That portal, I guess? Also, we haven't been back here in a while, so let's item hunt. Which of these was the weak one? Was it this one? It was this one. I think this one too. Man, I came back for a missile. Boo. I guess that's what most of these are gonna be, though. Just missiles. Although, did I ever grab that? Yeah, you take. Three more, can I find them all? Probably not. This is still one of the best songs in the game right here. I can listen to this for so long. It's like the Sanctuary thing, which is just like, it's so annoying everyone. That's another thing the first game does better, the music. Music in the first game is fantastic. every single area. This is an amazing thing. Oh, there are more than eight. Okay. I was wrong. I don't know how many there are in this game, then. I bet you can't hurt it like that. Oh, we can go right to it. First, though, is there anything down here? Whee! Nope, this water is shallow as fuck. Okay. Oh, the door's down here. I'm dumb. Putrid clove. It's one of these guys. He's just kind of hanging out. There's nothing happening in this room, okay? Guess I don't think. Oh, okay. Thought I heard an item. Well, shit, I guess we're down here now. Oh, that's terrifying. Those freaking worms. There you are. Let's come on. The other one is down there.
Is that below me? No, it's over here. The hell? Happened to chat there. Just twitch back to actually being able to catch the spam as it happens. So that's good. If that's the case. Does so much damage. I don't think your armor in this game actually increases your defense like it does in the first game. At least it sure doesn't seem to. What's so special about this room that they had to block it off with an annihilator door? All this for a missile. Once again, for not at all worth it. Unless you're going for 100%, in which case you have to. Feel worth the wait, you know? Wrenchlers? No! I'm not dealing with you assets. Actually, I seem to remember this one. You have to power bomb. I know, you just go down here. A lot of these are in water. What the fuck is this? A watch drone. Rogue sentry mechanoid. Indestructible but irritated by bright light. Target can be herded out of place by exposing it to light. They're not so much watch drones as they are just dudes that stay in place and block an area for a little bit. They don't really seem to do anything directly harmful, dude. Okay, that's both keys here. I think I already have one of them in the sanctuary. Reason to hang around here. Not really. Okay. Where was that thingy that led to sanctuary? This way. If I remember right, yep. Okay, and in Sanctuary, Hive Entrance, which is the one I suspected, and Hive Dynamo Works, which is the one I probably already have. It's more likely to be the one I already have anyway. Yeah, excuse me, I know exactly where we are too. Like run past you guys. Okay. I wish there was a portal down here, but there isn't.
save us so much time. Inventory. Miscellaneous. Dark Temple Keys, Sky Temple Keys. Hive. I keep looking for Sanctuary, but it's Hive. Siach is the one we already have. Logbook. Lore. Lumina. This is so tedious. Nicole's Clues, Codric Tomb. So Siach we already have. Looking down at the Great Bridge of a Holy Fortress. See, at least that one is way less vague. Because the only Great Bridge is the entrance to Sanctuary, so that one you could figure out easily enough. And the rest of this is just like among the trees. Somewhere with trees. But then you have the one that's just like a fortress in the sands. Like, that is vague as hell. That can be anywhere. I don't know. I'm just bitter with this entire portion of the game. It's very short, too. Like, after you beat Quadroxus, the end is just a hop, skip, and jump away. I don't like how small this game is. I mean, no Metroid game is really big when you really look at it, but I don't know, this one just feels really claustrophobic. This game is tiny. The other reason it feels so long is because the areas are so tedious to traverse. And there's just a ludicrous amount of backtracking, even for a Metroid game. I don't know. I still stand by my word when I say the first game did everything this game does, only better. Like, this is just the first game, but worse. I don't know, that's just me. I love the first Metroid Prime so much. I would love those two ammo upgrades, though. I have no idea where those two upgrades are. The last three E-tanks are optional. Should just be up here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Across the gap. Now it's just the main area. Nope, that hurts me. We're gonna finish this tonight. We're gonna finish this in like the next hour. I'm tempted to just go straight to the end now, but I really want those last two upgrades. I'll just look it up and see where they are. know I'm cheating like a motherfucker at this point, but I've stopped caring. I just want this done. Especially since no one's here. Like, Pegu was here. I don't know where he went, though. Pat probably fell asleep. Dane's at work, I don't know where Ellie is. I have more missiles than I have ammo. Like, jeez. I feel like I just missed one at some point, because I don't think they would save both of them until endgame. One of them for sure, but I'm pretty sure I just missed one at some point. Actually, yeah, with that save point, I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna pray my computer doesn't freeze during the frickin' intermission, but yeah, I need to go get my laundry and I need to, just stretch out a bit. So while I'm doing that, I will put on more Undertale music. Because Undertale music is awesome. I'll put on Core. That seems to be the most fitting for right now. So yeah, be right back.
We'll be right back.
I kind of just want to keep his music going. I don't want to go back to the other music. I have been listening to Undertale soundtrack and nothing but Undertale soundtrack for the last, like, week and a half. Hey, I said to get clothes. Actually, I'm in Sanctuary. Main research staging area. Reactor core, hive reactor. There's a room that I'm looking for. One of the ammo ups that I missed is in Sanctuary, which is fitting. Watch station, that's where it is. So it's in Light Aether. It's with all those, spider ball tracks. How did that guy get timed out? Are you here, Pat? Because I didn't do that. The question is, though, do I feel like going that way? Oh, I mean, we're right here. Oh, we're in Dark Aether, though. Oh hey, that one respawns. It's like the only one that actually respawns. I'm just gonna ignore him. I just don't know if I feel like going out of my way to get this ammo expansion. What the hell? And then the last one is endgame. It's actually right before the Sky Temple. You just need the Annihilator Beam and the Echo Visor. Yeah, I'll just use the portal over there. So I need to go this way? Yeah, that way. Just straight that way. I'm not going for all the items. Not by any means. I'm just gonna collect whatever ends up coming into my path. I will, however, go to my way to get these beam ammo ups. These jerks, though. Sneak attack! And you're dead. Okay, so I messed this up the first time. There's an ammo expansion up here somewhere. I just missed it the first time. Yeah. Oh. Here it is. I just did not even notice that path. Because the guide said, make sure to pay attention and look for a path heading north. Whoa! What the hell? I'm all sideways! Oh wow, that is actually really disorienting. I have never, ever seen any of the Metroid Prime games glitch, and now here we are in one stream, I've glitched this game twice. What the hell? How do I keep doing this? I don't know of any short ways back, so I guess we'll just take the long way. Is this gonna fix itself, or...? I imagine I just have to go back into Morph Ball, but I want to see how long this lasts. Oh my gosh. Welcome to Sideways Metroid. Whee. Okay, seriously though. Let's just fix that. Welcome to Sideways Metroid, please enjoy your stay. That just looks so much nicer having 200, like I should. And now we'll have 250 before long, because I know where the other one is. I don't know where any of the E-tanks are, though. So I'm just gonna hope I can beat the Emperor Ring with what we got. Cause I remember on hard mode I couldn't beat him with even the full 14. I had like every power up on hard mode. Well, not 100%, but like 90-something. Or at least 80-something. I had all the important power-ups, just not all the missiles. You can live without a few missiles. Missiles are literally just there for completion. You're not gonna go through 200. That quickly. And if you do, then damn. I hope they were worth it. Now I hit by all three of them. Wow. Things drop ammo. Looks like no. Just health and missiles. So screw them. Alright. Time to leave Sanctuary and never return. Because we are almost done with this game. Let's not forget that there's a turret directly outside this door this time. Ooh, can I go in here? Yep. What the hell's up here? I don't know how many of these light portals there are, or where they are. E-tank! Sweet! We're only missing two. I imagine the majority of the stuff I'm missing is in Sky Temple grounds, because we weren't really able to explore much of that. Which will change in a second. Just gotta find a portal. Is that one connected? Yeah, because we couldn't go in here because of the ink stone. Profane path is a key. I wonder if we already have that one. Hang on, let me just see which rooms have keys. Oh no, the profane path doesn't. Oh, the profane path is where the expansion was, that's right. Accursed Lake, Ing Reliquary, and Defiled Shrine are what I'm looking for. There's the Defiled Shrine. Reliquary is probably over there. And there's the Accursed Lake. So it tells me I already have two of those. Let me just check. There's miscellaneous, Dark Temple keys, Sky Temple keys, Temple grounds. Yeah, I already have two of them. So the other one we're missing is the one that we couldn't get previously because that path was blocked off. So this will be quick and easy. Part of me kind of wants to explore a little bit more, see if I can hunt down one of those last two E-tanks, or both of them, even. And anything else that we find. But the other part of me is just kind of like, it's 7:30, I just want to finish this game. Preferably before my computer freezes again. I think we have an hour and a half. If the pattern is still to be followed. Hi guys! How about no? This isn't super effective against higher commandos. I forget which one was which. This one? Nope. So it's this one. Alright. See you later, Pat. Have a good stream. I'll probably host you when I'm done, but like, there's nobody here, so I don't think it'll matter. But at least everybody will be working for the weekend, so. You know, there's that. You always duck out as soon as we get to the end games, like every time. I find that funny. Screw you, Metroid. In the first game, it probably works the same here, but if you opened a door and then had a Metroid dash at you, and then quickly stepped back into the door, the Metroid would hit the door as it closes and die instantly. how the ink storm is trying to kill me and failing. I was like, what is that noise? Also, what is the point of this? There's nothing in this room, okay. I'm not sure if I want to fight you guys in this incredibly enclosed space. Man, there's an entire pack of these guys in here. Look at this. I don't know where these two are. They freak out when you hit them once. Wow, it is so dark here. Ing reliquary. The next room is where it is. Yeah, I can't see anything without this on. Whoa. You can get lost. I don't know what the hell kind of spam that was supposed to be, but you can get lost. I got the second my moderator leaves, I get a spam bot. Metroid, come here. Try and eat me. That's what you get. Damn.
do anything, I'm going to go... save with the ship. Get all my ammo back. These troopers that we just kind of forgot about. Oh, I thought that was a piece of lore. I'm like, what? Our ship is just very slowly repairing itself as we go through the game. Alright, that feels better. So we need to go get all the way to that portal. The hole. Where'd they go? That portal right there. Go this way. I never opened this. God damn it.
secret missiles like just not work sometimes. That's also all we're missing at this point. Two E-tanks, I would imagine like one powerbomb expansion, because I can't see them ending at just an uneven number like that. And then a bunch of missiles. I'm not super bothered about those missiles. This game is just like much like Fusion, that everything does just ludicrous amounts of damage to you. Especially on hard mode, you will never have enough health on hard mode. Even with all 14 E-tanks, you still feel super weak. Just because everything does so much damage. You can now enter the Sky Temple. You know, the Ing could have stopped Samus by simply destroying the keys. I guess we're not allowed to have that. Sky Temple Energy Controller. But yeah, we missed like two lore. Possibly even just one. Missed a few items. Whatevs. I'm ready for this to be done. So yeah, this big-ass room, this is the last collection of planetary energy lies within the core. When you place it within the energy transfer module before returning to Aether, this world will become heavily unstable. This room is my final resting place in hard mode, because I can't beat Emperor Ring on hard. I just can't. Burning is just a giant Malboro. Emperoring body. Ruler of the Emperor. Target is drawing energy from the unstable energy controller. Eliminating target's connection to the energy may be an effective strategy. Bioscans indicate that this is the eldest, strongest Ing in the Horde, the Alpha and the Omega. It has absorbed enormous amounts of Phazon energy into its body, mutating itself in the process. Apparently, this power is not enough for the creature, as it is now siphoning energy from the final energy controller. Emperor Ing Head, ruler of the Ing Horde. Target will form numerous tentacles to defend itself. Eliminate them to weaken its defenses. Like its brethren, the Emperor Ing is a metamorph. It has molded itself around the precious energy controller and will defend it to the death, using its own body as a shield and a weapon. Destroy the tentacles it generates to weaken the creature and its defenses. This, so you can't back up too far. And it's really hard to stay locked on to these things. Unstable Ing biomass. Central eye is protected by a potent barrier shield. Shield does not provide complete coverage, however. The Emperor Ing has exposed its main eye, from which it can fire powerful energy beams. It is protected by a barrier shield, though not completely. The eye can be locked onto, but only direct shots will get past the shield. You avoid half of this. Can't avoid that. Because the only way to side dash is to be locked on. You can't fucking lock on those. Oh my god, this fight is retarded. Not even at the hard part yet. It gets much worse than this. Like an ink brush user. He has an attack where he just flails like an idiot. Then he eats himself. Burning Chrysalis, regenerating Angrily. Target's regen shell is magnetically charged. Even 11 weak points have been detected. Target them with Concussive Blast to shatter the regen shell. The heavily damaged Emperor Ring has entered a regenerative state inside a durable healing shell. Tactical scans have detected 11 weak points on the magnetically charged shell. Spiderball travel is possible on the surface. Damage the weak spots with explosives to crack the shell and expose the enemy within. Alright. This entire segment is just annoying. Healing up. I don't think power bombs are useful for any other part of this fight, so I may as well just use them all here. God damn. I can't even see these little guys spawn. God, that is frustrating. This is the hard part. Now we can move. Mutated Emperor Ring. Altered ruler of the Ying Horde. Further phase of mutation of the Emperor Ring has occurred. The creature seems to only take damage when its heart is light or dark. Find a way to change the heart to one of these colors. Further exposure to phase on has mutated the Emperor Ring. It is now capable of shielding its vulnerable areas with energy barriers. Beams of opposite polarity can damage these barriers, however. Heavy damage to the barriers will cause them to drop, exposing the creature's weak spots. Target the weak spots to immobilize and damage the enemy. Right. I'll just close his mouth. And his front leg is purely there as a shield. That didn't even hit him, apparently. I just remember this being super frustrating. Like, wow, his mouth was hard to hit. With how it's always moving. And then there's that bullshit. He's like a douchier Metroid Prime, which is saying something, because Metroid Prime is a huge douche. Like, oh my god, it's so hard to hit his mouth. Between it constantly moving and the frickin' shielding that it gets. Target you. And then I have to do that whole process again. Totally possible to avoid, right? Uh, eventually it'll start changing color out of will at will. Oh my god! It's like the phase on is just the room. What do you do when that happens? Seriously. Get to about this point, I'm hard, and then I just lose every time. Especially when he's like this, because I can't hit him. I can't hit him with the dark beam when he's like that. Just doesn't seem possible. Shots are too slow, and they just hit the underside of his mouth. So that's frustrating. You can really only hit him with light attacks. Oh my Christ, are you serious? No, you bastard. For fuck's sake, let me move. So that fight is just the opposite of fun. Who needs a transfer module? I'll just absorb it directly. I'd be thinking 8 minutes, that seems a little excessive considering the exit is right there. I'm sure it'll be fine. So I'm pretty sure that save point is now deactivated. Yeah. Seek another save station. You actually can't save at this point. You have to do the end game in one go. Man, I hope I have enough health for this. Now you're not looking too good. Dark Samus 3. Supercharged with Phazon energy. Targets Phazon energy weaponry and defense systems are full power. Phazon exposures render Dark Samus invisible to your dark visor. Scans indicate that Dark Samus has absorbed tremendous levels of Phazon into her body. Too much, perhaps. She can vent Phazon energy in the form of destructive blasts and protective shields. Doing so will help her maintain stability. Exposure to Phazon has rendered her visible to your dark visor. These new abilities combined with her already formidable arsenal place Dark Samus at the highest threat level. Oh, the game fully healed me, I just realized. That's awesome. Also, that super missile totally hit her. Which is cool, because I thought it didn't. Dark Samus 4! 98% of creatures. I missed a creature scan at some point. Unstable Phazon energy form. Target can generate shield immune to all forms of attack except Phazon energy. Draw an exalt Phazon for use as a weapon. Temporarily become a being of period unstable Phazon energy. She can generate a shield that is vulnerable to all attacks, save one. Blasts the Phazon energy itself. Use your charge beam to collect Phazon energy that she expels and fire it back at her. Direct hits will overload and disrupt her essence. And those home well. I don't know if there's a way to deal with that. I can't remember at all now, can I? Is that not what I'm supposed to be absorbing? Stop shooting missiles. It's my job. What the hell? Confused. I can hurt you. Slightly. Can't let any of them miss, I guess. Oh, I think I was scripted. Like, man, that missile did no damage. I think it was just get her to a certain level of health, and then she goes back into this. And we already did most of it with the Phazon Blast. Ironically, out of all her fights, this is the easiest one. No! What? I lost my luck on it. Fun. I guess neither was Metro Prime's second form. What this thing is expecting at this point. Can't go that way. For Superman pose in the air. In the air there. Even if those Aang were able to escape, it wouldn't have mattered because they would be under direct sunlight and they would just die anyway. Rad suits. All the other Lumina threw a week. Sam was just like, later, guys. I'm going home. Oh wait, I don't have a home. The old Zero Suit. I forgot she had her. Barbie makeover in this game. In the first game, she looks mostly the same, but a little different. She looks way more mature in the first game. The very brief look you get of her at the very end. You don't see her as Zero Suit or anything, because I don't think that was actually a design back in 2000. They made that later once Zero Mission came out. And that's it, game's over. I hate that ending so much. It's... I mean, there's nothing else you can really do about it. We save the planet, the Lumineth are all awake, everything's good, we're done. That's it, game over. I don't know. Just never felt worth it with how frickin' brutal that last fight is. I've also never seen the 100% ending. I should look that up. I managed to get it for the first game for the first time ever. That last YouTube playthrough I did a bit. I got all the items. Completely by accident, too. A bunch of them I just kind of stumbled upon. I'm like, wait, I don't remember ever finding this. And there was only one missile that I missed at the very end. And I'm like, okay, well, we're literally missing one item. We may as well grab it and get the best ending. So I went and did that. Turned out it was in a really obvious location, too. I just walked right past it for the first time. But yeah, not a bad game. I definitely prefer the first. And then the third game, while it's a little more linear, actually not really when you think about it. Like, in terms of story progression, it is, but you just kind of think back and it's like, well, all the games are linear at first, you just can't go anywhere until you get the abilities. The third game is good. I like the third game. I actually think I like the third game more than this game. But the first game is still the best. And then Hunters is just kind of Hunters. It's okay. The multiplayer was what made that game so much fun. I'm really sad that they never tried anything more with that. Like, the 3DS is the perfect system. Especially now they have the new 3DS. Like, they could do so much. Rest in peace, Satoru Iwata. There's so much they can do with, like, a Metroid Prime Hunters 2. A sequel on the new 3DS. I would totally get a new 3DS just for that. Because, like, all the new 3DS has is Xenoblade, and then, like, Monster Hunter looks a little prettier, and, like, that's it. There's really no reason to get a new 3DS right now. Unless you really want that, C-Stick. I've heard Smash players like it for the extra buttons and everything, but I play Smash on Wii U, so whatever. You! Is a person named You. And not the way you would expect it to be spelled. That's Jeff Miller. There's Nate Bildorf. It's the one name I always look for. Such a weird name. Shoemaker. Credits music isn't as good as the first game's. Which is basically just, like, the title music. It's like 11 and a half hours.
that's it. If I ever have anyone to play with, I might come back and do the multiplayer, because I remember enjoying that when I was a kid, but I don't know how well it would have aged. Probably not very. Hey, I actually did pretty much as well as I did on my other phone. And in less time, too. Wow. Let me just see how my hard file went. This was years ago, mind you. This game was stolen from me about 7 years ago. I didn't even have all the E-tanks. I'm missing one. Got all the research. Missing a few creatures, but I think some of those are like... Yeah, because those don't stick. Looks like I'm missing some lore. Did I have the super version of this? I can just never see a timer that's useful. Dudes. What the hell that's supposed to be? Instead we just got these guys and they suck. Like all the Federation guys in the third game are actually like legitimate soldiers, like they're actually really cool. Some of them anyway, not all of them. This weird music I keep hearing, don't mess with Samus. Wow, look at that. It's a terrifying light suit. Things. More things. All these things. Thank you.
hits. Their alphabet. God damn, I don't even touch it and it moves. Finished a game. I might do more side stuff and we'll just like test and see if my computer just really cannot handle this anymore. I might not be able to stream. Because if it's going to freeze up every single time I try, then I'm just, no. I don't have the patience for that. I'm just gonna play another medium again, screw it. So yeah, that was Prime 2. Didn't enjoy that nearly as much as I thought I would. No one's even here, so I don't even feel like doing much of an outro, but yeah. That's all for tonight. I might do something tomorrow if I'm not completely sidetracked with Undertale. I don't promise anything though. We'll see what happens. For now, enjoy the music. I'll see you guys later. Have a good night.